A creature so colossal that it rivaled the size of elephants and rhinoceroses. A behemoth that roamed the ancient lands of South and Central America, leaving awe-inspiring footprints in its wake. Meet Megatherium, a giant sloth that belonged to the family Megatheradi, and is renowned for its colossal proportions. It was not just any ordinary sloth, it was a true titan. A prehistoric giant that captured the interest of paleontologists and scientists alike. Megatherium was not alone in its immense size, as it had a close cousin named Remotherium that was equally massive. These gentle giants were part of the diverse order of animals known as Zenartha, which includes modern-day armadillos, anteaters, tree sloths, as well as the extinct pampatheres and glyptodonts. But Megatherium stood in a league of its own, as one of the largest land mammals that ever existed, only rivaled by the likes of elephants and giant rhinoceroses like Paraceratherium. The first discovery of Megatherium traces back to 1788, when a fossil specimen was found on the banks of the Luján River in Argentina. The holotype specimen was then sent to Spain, where it caught the attention of the esteemed paleontologist Georges Cuvier. Through comparative anatomy, Cuvier was the first to determine that Megatherium was a sloth, albeit unlike any other sloth that roamed the Earth. But how did it evolve to such colossal proportions? Megatherium's ancestors can be traced back to a smaller sloth known as Promegatherium, which was comparable in size to a rhinoceros. However, over time, it evolved to become much larger. By the late Pleistocene era, it had grown to the size of an African elephant, making it one of the largest land mammals to have ever existed. This colossal creature roamed tropical South America, Central America, and as far north as the southern United States. Its cousin, the slightly smaller Remotherium, also inhabited regions above the equator, with fossils found as far north as New Jersey. Part of the sloth family Megatheridae, this colossal creature is unlike any modern sloth we know today. While modern sloths are typically small, measuring less than a meter in length and weighing around 5 kilograms, researchers estimate that the Megatherium was up to 10 times larger, reaching weights of up to 4 tons and standing over 3 meters tall when standing upright on its hind legs. One of the most striking features of the Megatherium is its skeletal structure, which suggests that it walked long distances on all fours to distribute its weight evenly. Its short hind legs and wide pelvis also indicate that it likely spent a lot of time standing and sitting back on its hind legs and short, thick tail, creating a unique posture unlike any other mammal. But what truly sets the Megatherium apart are its enormous 7-inch claws. These massive claws made it impossible for the Megatherium to walk on the flats of its paws like other mammals, forcing it to walk awkwardly on all fours for extended distances. But it's not just the size and posture that make it a marvel of prehistoric biology. Its head and mouth are also intriguing. It had a strangely small head and mouth compared to other ground sloths of its time. In fact, it had the narrowest mouth among all ground sloths that existed during the Pleistocene epoch. Its head was larger in the back and narrowed down to the front in a cone shape, indicating that it was likely much more selective in the foliage it ate. One of the most intriguing aspects is the behavior that is their adaptability. These giant sloths were well equipped to thrive in a variety of habitats, from lush forests to grassy plains. They had a slow and deliberate gait, using their long claws to move around and grab onto vegetation, while their powerful muscles allowed them to dig for food with ease. With their specialized feeding adaptations, they were able to reach and strip leaves from even the tallest trees, making them highly effective herbivores. They were actually quite solitary creatures. They preferred a solitary lifestyle, spending their days leisurely browsing for food and resting in the shade of trees. However, they were also known to be highly territorial, fiercely defending their territory from any intruders. When it came to survival, the Megatherium had some unique strategies up its sleeve. One of the most intriguing behaviors of these giant sloths was their ability to climb trees. Yes, you heard that right. Despite their massive size and weight, Megatherium were actually skilled climbers. They used their strong forelimbs and sharp claws to grip onto tree trunks, allowing them to reach higher levels of vegetation and escape from predators. It's around 10,500 years ago, and the Megatherium, the giant ground sloth, is thriving in the lush landscapes of South America. But little did they know that danger was lurking just around the corner. It was found that human hunters were the primary cause of the Megatherium's downfall. These early humans had a taste for giant sloth meat, and they were relentless in their pursuit. Fossil evidence tells us that Megatherium remains have been found with cut marks suggestive of butchery, indicating that they were hunted and slaughtered for their meat. In fact, there's even a confirmed kill site in Argentina where a single Megatherium individual was mercilessly slaughtered and butchered around 12,600 years ago. Talk about a real-life predator versus prey showdown. But that's not all. Climate change has also played a role in their demise. The Quaternary period, during which these giant sloths roamed the Earth, was marked by drastic fluctuations in climate. South America, the home of Megatherium, experienced colder and more arid conditions as that period came to an end. Despite their best efforts to adapt, they couldn't withstand the dual onslaught of human hunting and changing climate. Hence, these two factors were the 1-2 punch that ultimately knocked them out and led to their extinction. There are rumors and tales of a beast still roaming the Amazon rainforest in South America that matches the description of the Megatherium. Could it be that this ancient giant sloth is not entirely extinct? While there's no conclusive evidence to support these claims, it's a tantalizing thought that keeps scientists and explorers on their toes, wondering if the Megatherium might still be lurking in the shadows, ready to make a grand comeback. But perhaps the most exciting thing is their lifestyle, which was its interactions with other animals. Fossil evidence suggests that these giant sloths coexisted with other megafauna of their time, such as saber-toothed cats, dire wolves, and mastodons. Can you imagine the epic battles that would have taken place between these ancient giants? It's a scene straight out of a prehistoric blockbuster movie. As we mentioned earlier, this massive sloth was not a carnivore, with its mouth and tooth structure suggesting it wasn't tearing through flesh or chasing down prey. But researchers have been scratching their heads trying to figure out if this giant sloth was strictly a herbivore or if it had a taste for something else. Talk about a paleontological puzzle! It had a more adventurous palate than we thought. Scientists believe that its primary diet was gritty and fibrous vegetation. It's like a vegetarian feast fit for a king. But some theories suggest that it may have dabbled in the world of meat-eating. This gentle giant may have had a hidden carnivorous side. It could have scavenged animal corpses to supplement its herbivorous meals. What an unexpected turn in the menu! In the world of research, it has been a subject of extensive study and analysis. Paleontologists and scientists have meticulously examined its fossils, teeth, and bone structures to unlock the mysteries of its anatomy, behavior, and evolution. This creature has also left its mark on popular culture in various forms of art, literature, and media. Artists and writers have also been inspired by this giant sloth. In art, it has been depicted in various forms, ranging from detailed scientific illustrations to imaginative and creative interpretations. Its overall creation has been brought to life through paintings, sculptures, other artistic mediums, and also made appearances in literature where it has been featured in fictional stories, children's books, and even comic books, adding a touch of prehistoric wonder to the world of imagination. It continues to be a source of fascination that keeps us hooked and begging for more by making its presence in media and popular culture. From documentaries and TV shows to movies and video games, it has been a sought-after subject for visual media. Even today, Megatherium continues to be a source of intrigue and captivation. Its fossils and remains continue to be discovered in different parts of the world, shedding new light on its history and evolution. Advances in scientific research and technology have enabled us to unravel more secrets about this ancient giant.